How the NAFA International Fleet Academy team created content to provide information for members on the international landscape.
It's another great event. It's the fourth in a row. We started with a pilot project in the NAFA offices, and since then we have been going and growing and developing content more. For NAFA, we are what you can call a content partner. We don't drive the bus. We are in the bus and we help find the right people to bring the right content and to really serve the need for providing information to NAFA members about the international landscape. So this is very much around NAFA members that we pitch for. Therefore, we also, especially this year, very happy with the mix between industry representation, which is very important because they provide necessary input, but also the amount of fleet managers that attend. We pitch for about 40 people in a room because that leaves a certain level of interactivity and comfort with people to exchange between one another. And we see that a lot, even during the coffee breaks, you know, we finish the presentation and they cling together and exchange information and anecdotes and war stories, and it's a really interactive, great event. And they appreciate hearing the stories from among themselves, and not just from the people that are also in the business to sell services, which of course we understand they need to do, and we're happy to hear because they sponsor the event. But it's important that these people have this level of comfort to do the exchange between themselves. As I said, it's the fourth in a row now, and I must say the level of education has increased a lot as too. The guest speakers, you know, become more comfortable with the topics. The members get more demanding, which is great because they push us to the next level, and we would like to see that. And also, yeah, it's a good mix of having a good venue, social activity in the evening, stick together, exchange even more, build relationships. I'm very pleased also with the feedback that you mentioned, and we hear this too. People are really ecstatic about the amount of information they get. I must say we are sometimes a bit concerned whether it's not too much, whether still people are able to absorb that at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, with also quite some people being in a slightly different time zone, which is not always evident, and that we have to bear in mind when we develop the program.